Hello friend, welcome back to my lecture on convergence of technology and industry 4.0. Basically, as per the recent timing, as per the current era, this era, convergence of technology is the requirement of the time, and we are having in the industry 4.0 era. And so you can see here how the technology has been growing and how the technology is evolving. So initially we have been this machine, and then we have switched on from mechanical system to we know the power of steam and power of water. Then suddenly we have started to develop this power of electricity, and we have started the electric motor, and this was the great revolution of that time. And then we have started assembly line production. So from the initial days to this era of industry 4.0, how we came this era of industry 4.0, so I am talking about this in this lecture. And the convergence of technology, now we are saying about the convergence of technology means we are saying about the combination of different technology. We are developing the new technology. So in this way we have developed, you can see in this slide, that industry 1.0, that was the time of mechanization, that was the time of steam engine, steam and power of water. We know that time factory system we have started at the industry 1.0 time. And then industries, then came the next industrial revolution, that was industry 2.0, that was mass production, assembly line production, electrification and globalization all across the world. And this was the industry 2.0. we have started in 2.0, assembly line and electrification. Electrification is was the big development of industry 2.0. and then industry 3.0, that was the very emerging development, that was computing. And computing has been started in industry 3.0, and internet also started that time. Emergence of internet is known by the people and known by the industry, and autonomous production has been started at that time, at time of industry 3.0. ERP, CRM software has been started that time. But today this industry 4.0, that is amazing. We are talking about the cyber physical system, we are talking about the big data, we are talking about artificial intelligence, robotics, internet of things. So in this era we have been all these technologies, and we are using all these technology, convergence of all these technology, we are creating the new technology. So all industrial revolution started with the introduction of disruptive technology, which acted as a change agent across the industry. So industrial development, industrial revolution, this great industrial revolution is leading towards new era of the technology, and it is redefining the manufacturing. So this was the great development, and we are saying industry 4.0. this is called industry 4.0. and the better the question, better the answer, better the world works. So we are saying this slogan right now, and we are talking about the cyber physical world. So this is the fourth industrial revolution, and this is the robotic revolution, we can also say automatic robotic revolution. And now what is convergence? Convergence means the combination of different technology collection by cooperating, by coordinating, by combining all the technology, we are developing new technology. We have been leading technology, we have social businesses, we have big data analytics, we have cloud technology, we have mobile technology, robotics are there, natural interfaces, 3D printing, internet of things, cognitive system, next gen security, and we have been so many technology, and abundance of this new technology, efficiency dear future scope is the great. And so we are talking about all these technology, and this is called convergence of technology, convergence of business ecosystem, and convergence of the people, application, thing, data, devices. So we are collecting all the people, we are collecting and converging all applications, people, thing, data, devices. We are converging all the things. We are converging all the technology and creating the new technology, and we are going towards this new era, and this is called Industry 4.0. And you also know these fads. We never know about iPhone, iPad, Kindle, 4G, Uber, Android, Instagram, Snapchat, WhatsApp. Before 2006, we never heard the name of these technologies, these things, these items. We never heard their name, but now they are all are the part of our life, and they are very essential part of our life. And you can also know this fact. We should know this fact that telephone has taken 75 years to reach 100 million customers, and web has taken 7 years to reach 100 million customers. Facebook has taken 4 years to reach 100 billion customers. Instagram has taken 2 years to reach 100 million customers. But Pokemon Go like game is taking only 1 month to reach 100 million customers. So where is the world is going now? You can see what is the use of technology now. You can guess the new use of technology and how technology is important for new era and new generation. So this statistics show the use of computing and use of technology in this era. And we are talking about the cyber physical world, where communication, control, computation, information flow, and physical things, cyber physical system is connected with each other. And somehow we are talking about the computation, communication, controlling, everything is in this cyber physical system. And this is Industry 4.0. cyber physical system is a system of collaborating computational element controlling the physical entity. So this is cyber physical world, and how this technology has been evolved. So you can see that in the slide, evolution and e-journey, the process from the manual to mechanical. Manual, we have been started from manual, then we move to the mechanical, and finally we move to the automated smart AI learning, AI machine learning, IoT. And we have been lot of list which will see in the coming slides we can see. So this way we have been moved towards this technology, towards this new era of the technology. And today we are talking about the manufacturing. This is not manufacturing, we are talking about a digital manufacturing. So this is the old manufacturing, this is the era back manufacturing. So this is the new manufacturing, and this is robotic manufacturing. This is Industry 4.0, where robots are working and robots are preparing. So we have been different kinds of robots. We have been different robots for different duties. You can see that in the slide. So everything is preparing by the robots, and the business of robot, it is expected in 2009 it was 135 billion global annual investment on robots. So this is the statistics, and we are moving towards this 135 billion business on robots, and we are moving so fast on robotic world. And we are talking about the digital era, and this is called tomorrow's manufacturing is a smart and digital manufacturing. Big data, predictive analysis, virtualized process, modeling and simulation, high performance computing, robotics are the new era computing. And digital manufacturing, smart and digital manufacturing, we are talking about smart and digital manufacturing, not pollutant creating manufacturing. So this is the new era manufacturing. And IoT and smart manufacturing products, we have been a smart product. Now we have we are creating the smart products. And physical, we have been physical component, that is electrical and mechanical component, smart component. We have sensors, we have microprocessor, we have the storage, control, software, embedded operating system, digital user interfaces, and wireless connectivity is there, and ports, antenna. We have been so lots of the technology, many technology which we have, and we are combining these technology and creating the new systems and new items and new technologies. So smart component, physical component, and connectivity component, they all together are creating the smart products. So we are moving towards a smart product, and This is the tomorrow manufacturing. This is the tomorrow. This is the future of tomorrow. We have been huge machines. These machines are creating the huge productivity. And who has the highest productivity improvement? So you can see here these big machines. They are creating a lot. And like in the field of mining, 1% today does the work handled by the 30 people of 40 years. Up to 40 years, how much 30 people up to 40 years they are doing, that much work is done by one machine, by 1%, by one machine in a day. So this is the capacity of today's machines and today's human resource. So according we have been so huge and large machines, and so to operate these machines, fulfill the requirement of this industry 4.0, we require worker 4.0, as well as we require the knowledge, education 4.0 or teacher 4.0, who can train the manpower according to the need of industry 4.0. So we are talking about the industry 4.0. we are talking about the worker 4.0 also. So this is the new manufacturing era and new era of the industry and new era of the technology. So we have been this industry, we have we require autonomous robot in industry 4.0 and simulation. We require system integration, we require the expert of Internet of Things, we require expert of cyber security, we require expert of cloud computing, expert of additive manufacturing, we require the expert of augmented reality, we require the expert of big data. So we require so many skills. So government is saying about the Skill India program, so that's why we require the skilled manpower on these fields. So we have to prepare our manpower, prepare our technologists such a way that they can fulfill the demand of all these technology. And the makers of fourth industrial revolution, we can also say the makers of fourth revolution are biotech, nanotech, neurotech, green renewable and ICT, mobile technology, 3D, AI, robotics, sensing, space technology, drones. They all are the makers of the fourth industrial revolution. So we are moving towards this direction. We need such these experts. So we have to skill, we have to train our skilled manpower. We have to develop these skills in between the students, between the community. And cloud is one of the biggest resources. We have been so powerful devices, like mobile is one of the powerful devices because we have been cloud computing. In the background of this mobile, this smart device, this laptop, we have been a huge network of cloud computing. So cloud computing, basically this is the network of computer. And initially, we have been during 1960, we have mainframe computer, we have the concept of mainframe computer. During 80s, we have client server or personal computer. And today, we are talking about the cloud computing. Everything is on cloud. So in between, we have been personal computer, client server computer, web computing, and finally, we have been this cloud computing. And this is very beneficial computing. And this is really the emerging and one of the emerging technology. So cloud computing is an internet based computing whereby the shared resources, software, information provided to computer and other devices on demand like electricity grid. So as per the requirement, we share or we rent on cloud, and this is like we are taking electricity from the electric grid. So same way we are taking computing and we are renting computing from the cloud or data centers. So as per our requirement, so this is cloud computing. Basically this is the idea behind this cloud computing according to Wikipedia. So we have been so many computing. Now we are talking about the this computing. We have been so many devices, we have been so many smart devices, and so we have entered on the era of pervasive computing. And while we are on the office, we have been a device. We are in the home, we have been device. Today we are doing all the businesses, all the work from home, and everything is doing by these devices. So we are surrounded by number of devices, and this is called pervasive computing era. And this is the new era of computing where we require only connection, and sitting anywhere, any place of the world, we are connected with the server. This is the older world where we have to look after the networking, we have to look after the computing hardware, everything we have to see. But today this is the faster world, and this is based on the better performance, and here we have to connect. We need only one single internet connection, and through this connection we are connected with the whole world. And the work from home culture has been developed. So we have been SaaS and S, software infrastructure, platform and infrastructure, and infrastructure as service, platform as service, software as service. So we have all the software, platform, infrastructure, everything is on cloud. As per requirement, we rent all the things, and we have the power of thumb, we have the power of connection right now, and this is the great thing. And we have been these smart devices are so powerful, and anywhere, any place they are connected. And they have huge resources. These smart devices having the huge resource, but not in their memory, but it is connected with cloud, and from cloud we are having all the data, all the resources. So we have been so powerful because we have these smart devices, and these smart devices are so powerful because they are connected with the cloud. So cloud is one of the biggest resources, and these are some snapshot of the cloud data center. So basically this cloud is backing by the huge data center. So a data center, one data center is 11.5 times the size of football field. So this is the size of data centers. So huge data centers all over the world. We have been many, have seen many data centers, like data centers of Google, data center of Microsoft, data center of Oracle. So these data centers are spread across the 10 to 12 football ground area. They are covering this area. Some of the data centers are underground, some of the data centers are on Mars, some data centers are cold ice cap area of the Antarctica. So these are the different data centers of spread all across the world. You can see this diagram. This is the data center which is underground in Japan, so on Siberia. So these are the exotic location of the Siberia, cold Siberia, and Sun has established these data centers on underground. So moving data centers on different exotic location. So these are the different data centers. Google, Microsoft, IBM, they have different data centers. So Google has data centers on Singapore, Taiwan, Hong Kong. IBM has its data center on China. So big companies, Facebook had its data centers on North California. So the companies has established and started their data centers in the different area of the world, and we are backing by these data centers. We are getting the data from these data centers. So this is the new era technology. This mobile phone is so powerful right now. The older one is changed in the newer one. So we have been innovated, changed the technology of older one, and we have been new Android device, and this device is so powerful, and this is integrating all the devices. This is integrating the information, and this new world and the older world where only one channel, only some of the channels, selected channel are generating the information. Today everybody is generating the information. This is the new world and new concept. All are consuming the data, all are generating the data. So but in the previous world, in the older world, few print channel and few media channel, electronic channel, only they are producing the data, and everybody is consuming this data. So but now the concept has been completely changed. it is 360 degree change, and everybody is producing the data. So we have been the concept of the big data, huge amount of data. We have been huge amount of educational information. We have huge amount of the climate information, social media information, digital information, digital picture information. We have huge amount of videos, YouTube videos, purchase record, purchase information, sales information, cell phone, GPS signal, and this is called big data. So we are expecting 2.5 trillion byte of data, and so much that the 90% of the data of the world today has been created last 2 years alone. So this is the new world, this is the new era of technology, and we have been huge amount of data, and this huge amount of data is the huge resource for we all technologists, and we can extract very many meaningful and information from this data. So we have large variety of data, large velocity of data, and large volume of data. Large volume of data, large variety of data means different, we have been different type of data, and velocity means 1 second is two, 1 second is too late, 2 minutes is too late, means within 2 minutes we are extracting huge amount of data. So this is the latest I have heard, 10 nanosecond delay is too much. So this is the velocity. So we have data of TV, data of print media, data of email, data of ad services, data of web analytics, social media data, mobile data. So huge amount of data we have been, and scientific instruments are creating huge amount of data, social media is creating a huge amount of data, mobile devices are creating a huge amount of data. So this way sensor technology is creating a huge amount of data. So we have been different, we have social media, gaming, entertainment media, purchase history data, save data, banking data. So huge amount of data we are creating. So single view of the customer. So customer is creating, say customer, banking customer, maybe the gaming customer. So we have collected, we have starting too much data. So this is a guess on how much data we are creating. So up to 2003, how much data we are collected up to 2003, that much data in 2001, same amount was created every 2 days, and in 2013 the same amount of data is created in 10 minutes, and now data is increasing exponentially. Maybe the data up to 2003, that much data is created in 1 second or within nanosecond. So this is the speed of data creation. So we are creating the huge volume of data in the world. So so this way our human resource, the traditional approach or traditional software are not capable to handle this data, and traditional human resource or manpower is also not capable to handle this data. So we need to scale up our system, we need to scale up our human resource, and so that they can capable to handle this data, and system need to be scale up. The old machines, old transportation medium is not capable to handle this data, because we have been huge population, we have been huge amount of data. So we have to manage this data, and we have to analyze this data, and we need to learn new softwares like Hadoop, MapReduce. Hadoop basically used to extremely high volume data, is handle high volume of data. Hadoop distributed file system, HDFS, is capable to handle the huge file system, distributed file system. MapReduce is the programming paradigm, managing the application on multiple distributed server. So this way, these are the different softwares, and we have been many more softwares. We are moving towards machine learning, we are moving towards other softwares, R software. So different type of the software, so they are beneficial for handle this data, and we have to learn new technology in every field. Cassandra is one of them, edge-based, like D-based, Fox-based, Fox Pro. We have been edge-based, we have been Cassandra to deal with the non-relational database design for use with the Hadoop, and Hive is also query language, one of the important query language, SQL, we can say SQL. So similar to SQL. So this is an important language. Big data requires big network. So big data requires big software to handle new software to handle the data, and new or bigger network to store or to handle this data. So this is the need of technology, need of time, and big data analytics is the emerging field. Large scale data management is the emerging field. Data science and analytics is one of the emerging fields. How to manage very large amount of data and extract value from the knowledge from them. This is the challenge for the researcher, for the computer scientist. And finally, we can say that data is an asset. So this is very important. And deeper customer knowledge is very essential so that we can extract them meaningful information from the customer, that customer, which customer wants which type of the item. So we can customize the ad for particularly for the group of customer or particular customer. So identify the characteristic of the portable customer. So we can start portability in ad marketing. So this is the direction, and this is the new era, and predict the next big product, and more accurate marketing is required now. So now we have been this along with this big data, we also require, or we also developing towards the direction of the Internet of Things. So this is also next generation internet technology. Internet is very important for this new era, this industry 4.0, as we are talking about the computer with the physical world, cyber physical world. So IoT is very important. So this basically this IoT, where we are connecting billions of devices through internet, and internet enabled devices we are creating. So this is expected that according to Gartner, IoT installed base will grow 26 billion units by 2020. So that is according to Gartner, and this number might be low, and it will be more in up to the end of the 2020. It is expected that every mobile, every automobile, every door, every room, every part of every part list of our day-to-day life, they all are connected to the internet. It is expected, and they are connected through sensor. Sensors are all across, all around. We require number of sensors. We require new machines with the sensor. We require sensor on bed, sensor of chair, sensor of basket. Or we require number of sensor in home, office, building, hospital. Everywhere we requiring the sensor. So this is the new era of the computing. This is the IoT, and it is expected that 50 billion devices will be connected by the internet. And the world population, on the other hand, world population is 7.6 billion. So we have been lots of devices. We are creating, generating lots of devices, and these devices are connected with the internet. So this is the future of, this is expected of 2020. So this is the future of technology, and it is expected that on an average 6.58 sensor having each person, or connected devices having each person, means around 7 sensor devices, 7 IoT based devices will be having each person. So this is the future, and development are going on, lots of new technologies. You can see in Microsoft Office, you can see the robotic security guard, and autonomous car is the new development. Google is trying lots of, Google is doing lots of experiment on this autonomous car, nanorobotics. They are doing on nanorobotics, and these are different usage of mobile. Mobile, one mobile is capable around 14 gadgets. Mobile is so important. It becomes a essential part of our life. You can see, or you can do everything through by the mobile. Camera is in the mobile. It is a speaker on the mobile. It can sense our sound. Everything it can sense, and one mobile is capable to around 14, more than 14 gadgets. So we can do eye examination. We can do heart monitoring by the mobile. We can perform air we can perform air monitoring or air view by the mobile using some accessories. Glucose management is possible through the mobile, and imaging is possible. X-ray imaging is possible through the mobile. Smart pills are directly connected with the mobile. So we have been so many functions which can be performed by the mobile. So mobile is very important, and we have been sensors. We have been lots of sensors. They are benefiting the humans, and sensor on mobile, sensor on robots, sensor on our cameras, sensor on huge big systems. So everywhere we are using sensors and sensor processing. We are telling about the sensor as service. So along with the software as service, platform as service, and infrastructure service, we are talking about sensor as service. So huge amount of sensor and lots of sensor are on the cloud, and we can use these sensors. So sensor processing as service, this is the new term scheme, and everywhere we are using the sensors. So this is the new era, and basically we know all these systems. We know the sugar check machine, we know the fitness band, we know this type of the sensor, we know the sensor on our devices, sensor on the electrical appliances, we know different type of image sensor devices. So we have been so many devices, but these devices are working partially. They have been sensors. They are connected with the internet. Some of them are connected to internet, some of them are not connected to internet, but it is expected that all the devices in near future, all the devices will be connected to internet. So then we will call it a complete system. So we can have the idea of sensor-based, sensor door, sensored this coffee making machine. While moving from our office, we can start our coffee making machine. When we will reach the home, the coffee will be ready. So this type of the system, slowly and slowly, this type of the system has been the part of our life, and they have been companies are launching this type of the system, and we are using lots of sensor on the agricultural machine. So we have seen this type of the machine. We have seen huge machine, but without sensor. So we have an idea, if we can connect our toys of our kids with the sensor, we can play these toys from remotely. So why not we can play all these big machines through sensor, so remotely. So farm machinery are also in the future, they will be sensored with devices, and we can sitting inside the home, we can control our tractor, we can control our system, we can control how much the field is plowed by the tractor. We can see it. We have been GPS. We can see all the things. So this is the future. This is the future technology. This is the future machines, and lots of sensors on agriculture, and when to re-irrigate, when to re-fertilize, and under ocean we have different sensors. So sensors, camera, nano sensors on the ground, ocean, autonomous vehicle, airship. So everywhere we are using the sensor. These are the lots of benefit of these sensors, and we have been this portable and smart solar system, smart irrigation system, where we have been small machines which automatically sense the field condition and moisture of the field, and automatically start the irrigating to the field. So this type of system we are expecting. Solar charging stations are there. They have been started in different area of the world. So we are expecting the intelligent home, where all the devices are connected with the internet, and everything is connected and controlled by this mobile phone. So suppose we have parked our car on the garage. Suppose the door is opened, somehow we left the door, one door of the car is not closed, and automatically it will sense, and it will alarm to our mobile phone that the system that the car is not properly closed. So this is the future expected system, and expected intelligent home, intelligent automobile, internet based and automobile. So so suppose we are going to some tour, then our car is automatically sense the condition of the petrol, condition of the air pressure in the tire. So automatically it will suggest us the nearest petrol pump, nearest automobile mechanic shop. So all the things are automatically connected, and in case of any emergency it will automatically connect or alarm to the fire station or police station, so in case of any adverse condition. So these are the system and these are the automatic system of the based on the Internet of Things. So this is the future, this is the new era of the technology, new era of the system. This is the smart loop found in the Heathrow Terminal 2. These smart loops have embedded sensors and track the people's movement and bathroom flow, and can alert the maintenance crew if there is a problem. So these all are automated, and there is no manual staff required to clean all these smart loop. So you can imagine that how the technology is going, how the technology will move in future. And this is people connecting things. Now we are talking about the internet, along with the Internet of Things we are talking about the people connected thing, where we are connecting the humans with the internet based devices, internet enabled devices. So in this example you can see here moisture sensor is attached or in the body of motion sensor, as well as ECG sensor is attached inside the body, in the body of the human, and which is connected to the internet and directly sending signals to the cloud, and cloud based software will automatically sense the condition of body, condition of ECG, condition of movement. So accordingly they will alarm in case of any adverse situation. Suppose the person having attack or any blood pressure up and down, so in this case it will automatically alarm in our mobile phone that any adverse condition. So they are connected directly with the ground station, ground hospitals and databases. So this is people connecting thing, where people connecting two things, where people are connected with the internet enabled devices. And we have also did some work in this direction in IoT, so automated IoT based smart water quality assessment system. This was under USARC, Uttarakhand Science Education Research Center. So we have done a quality assessment system, quality assessment devices, which we have we have sent to patent. So in these devices we have microcontroller, Arduino, GSM modules, and we have different sensor, PS sensor, turbidity sensor, TDS sensor, temperature sensor. So we are sensing all the parameter of the water through different sensor, and sending through GSM module to our mobile system or our center system. So this is a view of our device. You can see here a view of device. This is solar, it is solar powered, and these are the four sensors in it. So completely this is the implementation of IoT, and we have used basic framework of the IoT things, where we are collecting the data and through it we are sending the data to the center server. So somehow we have been different centers, and we can connect it with the new one microcontroller, new devices. So these are the different experiment. We also did same work on the soil quality assessment, and doing lots of work in the different direction. So the IoT is the future, and IoT is the new era computing, and robot is new era computing. And now the concept is learn, unlearn and relearn. So this is the new concept, and according to Alvin Toffler, the illiterate of the 21st century will not those who cannot read and write, but those who can learn, unlearn and relearn. So this is the ongoing learning all the time. We have to learn new concept and revise this concept and relearn this concept. So accordingly change according to the time, according to situation, we have to change all these. So we are talking about, now we are talking about cyber physical worlds, fusion of cyber physical. So man is not so powerful right now. Man and machine together becomes powerful. So fusing of the physical, digital and biological world. So this is the intelligent connected world, and man-machine interface is required and necessary in this era. Man-machine supremacy. So we are talking about the man-machine supremacy. We are talking about the SOFIA. SOFIA is the big development of this era, and SOFIA is the first robotic citizen of the world from the Saudi Arabia. So SOFIA can express her view on any topic. She can give extempore speech on any topic. So last year she was in India. So it was a big development for the computer scientists. And Ross intelligence, we are talking about the Ross intelligence. Ross lawyer, we are talking about the Ross lawyer. Automated vehicle, autonomous car. So these are the bigger development. 3D printer is one of the bigger development. Cloud based robotics, and now we are talking about the robotics, cloud enabled robotics. We are remotely, we are running or operating our robots. So cloud based robotics from the Google has started this robotic. Industry 4.0 is, again I am telling you, Industry 4.0 is big development. It is the world of the cyber physical world, where anything is likely to revolve around the machine and cyberspace. So one, multitasker bots, we have been new concept of the bots, AI based bots are giving the answer. They are suggesting, they are the expert system of the new era. From the momentum machine can make a gourmet hamburger in 10 seconds. So it could soon replace the entire McDonald's crew. So this is the big development. Within 1 second we are creating the hamburger by these machines, multitasker machines. So this is the new future. Google won the patent of the start building worker robots with personality. So Google has started going on this direction. Google is doing lots on in AI and speech recognition. 7 million homes are connected with this, having this machines, AI and speech recognition. Alexa is one of them. Alexa of Amazon, Siri of Control, Echo, and Google Home. They are the new development. They are the part of our life, and they are essential element of our life. These are the example of machine learning, and so many machine learning example. And we are talking about the IBM Watson. Watson is the big development. Machine learning, 3D printing, lots of development of this new era. Augmented reality, AI, computational thinking, robotics, and these are the different developments. 3D printing is one of the big development. We can create any type of the shape. We can create, we can prepare pizza by this machine. This is the expect, we are thinking, we are, this is the thinking, this is the expectation, and this is the sense of the new era, where we can prepare burger, we can prepare pizza by this machine. So this is the new era. Cupcake is prepared by this machine. So yes, actual cupcake ATM, this is the actual cupcake ATM. This is the sense of new generation, how we are moving towards which direction. So confectionery 3D printer, so this is called confectionery 3D printer. This had not have, this is not happened before before this era. So there are spankiest cupcakes ATM in the several cities in the United States, including the Hills and Chicago, New York, and so in they are frequently in the different area of the United States. We have been so much powerful machine 3D printer. We have been so powerful 3D printer, which can due to these machines, due to these printers, 3D knitting is possible. We can prepare this by the printer. We can prepare these type of the cloths by the 3D printer. So knitting is possible, and we have been drone, different type of the drone is possible. And drone is the they are benefiting us in the different way, in the different area, different field. So this is the future. Drone is the future. 3D printer is the future. Industry 4.0 is the future. Bioscience, cell-free protein synthesis is the future. So we are doing lots of in this during this crisis. This is helping us in developing all these things. virtual reality. This is the new technology. So we can say as TV watch wheel on our class, into our class, all this happening today in this era. So this is possible. This is we can having this TV like experience on our mobile. So cyber security is one of the important area of this new technological era. So cyber crime or cyber security is very important and very essential. So we have to expect this cyber security also. So finally, we can say the convergence of technology, convergence of different technology, creating the new technology. So this convergence can scale up the system, can scale up the devices, and large scale IoT, big data, testing, experimentation, and these all are the future. And IoT, big data, cloud computing are the future of the world. So thank you very much. Thank you.